Dictation start now.
I should therefore like Parliament to remember these basic things. Here is something that is proposed which in effect clarifies and elucidates the Constitution and brings it completely in line with what the makers of the Constitution intended. Unfortunately, they did not do so in clear enough language, and therefore the courts have interpreted it definitely. So, first, it is a matter of elucidation. Secondly, it is wrong to say that we are suggesting any arbitrary action, any confiscatory action, or any expropriatory action. In fact, the Constitution has said that there should be compensation by law. But it is true that the quantum of compensation will be determined and by the legislature. I cannot say of and hand what in a particular case the legislature might do. But and by and large, if you have to govern this country democratically, you have to trust the legislature not only in this but in 100 other matters of far greater moment. This legislature might decide on some far-reaching change affecting perhaps a question of such magnitude as war and peace. Surely the Supreme Court will not decide that. It may decide other questions in ways which directly or indirectly might even affect property. All kinds of decisions may be taken which will have a powerful effect on our social and economic structure and, for example, on planning. But it is the legislature's will that is bound to prevail in such matters. There is no way out of it. It seems to me a basically wrong approach to single out this question of compensation and to take it out of the purview of the legislature in the sense of somebody else revising the legislature's decision. Such a course can be thought of only if you think that property is something semi-divine and that the protection of private property is to the largest good of the nation, which hardly anyone today will say obviously. I do not know how I can deal with these fears and apprehensions. There is no remedy for fear except the absence of fear. Today in the larger world context, nations are afraid, and because they are afraid, they often say and do the wrong things. These things thus get worse. I do not know what we shall do about it. In the international sphere, some people in this country and some outside have all manner of apprehension on this vital issue. In this transitional age, to think in a static way and to imagine that properly has exactly the same place in human life as it used to have means that we have stopped thinking. These apprehensions and fears therefore appear to me completely unjustified. Far greater developments and disasters might suddenly confront the world, and in this context for somebody to be afraid of some mill or plant or factory being acquired seems to me out of proportion so far as this government is concerned. My mind is perfectly clear on the subject. I have no respect for property except perhaps some personal belongings, but I respect the other person's respect for property occasionally. The house will forgive me if I speak in a personal sense. I have no property since it seems a burden to me carry property. It is a nuisance in life's journey. One should be lightly laden. One cannot be tied to down to a patch of land or a building. I cannot appreciate this instance attachment to property, but while not appreciating it, I realize and recognize its prevalence. At the same time, I think the proposition that some honorable members on the opposition side advanced about acquisition of conviction without compensation seems to me basically wrong. I say so from the point of view of the public good, not because I love property, except in particular cases where a person misbehaves and so on. I do not want anything to be acquired except on payment of just compensation. I need not refer to foreign capital here. I am surprised to hear the proposal being put forward repeatedly that we must confiscate or appropriate foreign capital. I cannot imagine anything more thoughtless and unrealistic. It has no relation to reality. No country where it is socialist or communist or of any other type can do it except in the thunder of war or revolution, when things happen not because of law or policy, but because of historical forces. I am quite certain that the Soviet Union will never do it. In regard to any foreign capital that may be there, it will not do it because international relations will be affected. No country wants to spoil its international relations or its credit in the world by doing this kind of thing in order to save a few crores or a few millions in financial terms. Soviet Russia, leaving the revolution aside, has had dealings with other countries and it has developed a reputation of always honoring its word, financial word, other European countries have not done so sometimes, but the Soviet Union has done always.